Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. This video is the prototype for what you'll get in the following months, since if you have read my latest community post, a sudden illness forced me to skip one of my most important exams. For this reason, at least until February, there won't be any more complete farming guides, and instead, if I have enough time, you will get this type of videos. The only exception will be the next Christmas lottery, for which I will try my best to give the usual complete farming guide. Enough with the introduction, now let's take a look at the usual farming efficiency analysis for this event. Comparing the 3 level 90 single nodes to the latest level 90 plus mixed node. This time around I've made 2 separate analyses, one for the shop currencies and another one for the building materials, the ones that are needed to improve your harvesting quests. Let's start with the shop currencies. Assuming you still need all 3 currencies to clear the shop, the simple rule is to farm mixed node if you have few gacha seeds, or single nodes if you have a lot of gacha seeds. More precisely, the only reason to farm a single node is using a lot of gacha seeds for that node, but not being able to use all of them while farming the mixed node, aka not having good farming setups. To give you some numbers, the mixed node for this event is very good. In fact, it's the second best of all events in the past year, on the same footing as Fate Requiem and Servant Summer Camp 2022. Since even free-to-player setups have 3 slots available for seeds, you should only consider farming single node if your single drop bonus is 5 or higher. In order to give you the usual complete criteria, let's call X your single drop bonus while farming the single nodes, and Y your mixed drop bonus while farming the mixed node. Simply count the number of gacha seeds you can use in your farming setups, remembering that a Maxlin broken copy counts as 2. Mixed node is better than single node AP-wise, if the inequality on the top of the screen is satisfied. Equivalently, you can use the graphical method below, drawing the points of coordinate X and Y, and if that point falls in the blue region above the blue line, then mixed node is better. As usual, I have simplified the equation a bit in order to make calculation easier. Instead, the graphical method is 100% correct. Now for the usual number representing the strength relation between single and mixed node. Assuming you can use all the seeds for the single node, even for the mixed node, aka you are not limited by your farming setups, but only by the number of gacha seeds you have summoned, then mixed node is surely better than single node AP-wise if your single drop bonus is at most 6. As I said previously, the only 2 events in the past year that have this number were Fate Requiem and Servant Summer Camp 2022. The only event this year with a mixed node that was better than this, compared to its single nodes, was the recent lottery event Land of Shadow 2022. As was the case with the previous events, even for this one, since the mixed node is so good, you can still farm mixed node even with only 2 currencies needed to clear the shop. In general, the simple rule is to farm the 2 single nodes in any case. More precisely, the only reason to farm mixed node is having a lot of different gacha seeds, but not much of the same type, aka low single drop bonus. Or alternatively, not being able to use all of them while farming the single node, aka not having good farming setups. This last case is more rare, since the mixed node is the most difficult one to farm, so usually if you can afford a good farming setup for the mixed node, you should also be able to afford a good farming setup for the single nodes. But of course this can depend on your roster of servants. To give you an idea with numbers, even with only 2 currencies needed, mixed node is still better than single node if you don't use any gacha seed, aka zero drop bonus for both nodes. Of course, this is only an example to give you the numbers, since it's not practical. You should always be able to choose at least one support with a gacha C. For the complete criteria, we proceed as before, but now for the mix of drop bonus, you should only count the materials that you still need. You can use both the inequality on the top of the screen or the graphical method below. As before, I have simplified the equation in order to make calculation easier. With the usual final assumption, we can see that the mixed node is surely better than single node AP-wise, only if the single drop bonus is at most zero. In other words, this time you'll always need to check the complete criteria in order to decide. Now that we have seen how the mixed node compare to the single nodes in regards to shop currencies, we'll now see how the situation changes when it comes to the building materials. Assuming you still need all three materials to improve your harvest, the simple rule is to farm the single nodes in any case if interested only in the building materials. More precisely, the only reason to farm mixed node is needing only few building materials or caring more about shop currencies. In particular, once you have maxed your harvest, you should refer to the previous section regarding shop currencies. When it comes to building materials, the mixed node is not very good compared to the single nodes. It's also more difficult to farm, so fewer bonus servants can be used in the backline. Since even older chain setups can afford two slots of bonus servants in the backline, there is no simplified criteria and you should always check the complete rule. In fact, mixed node is surely better when using only a single drop bonus, aka only a single bonus servant in both nodes. For the complete criteria, we proceed as before, but this time, instead of counting the gacha seeds, we'll count the number of bonus servants. All of them count by one, except Himiko, Nobukatsu and Saito for the mixed node. If bringing them to the mixed node, they will count as three, so be sure to make the correct calculations. You should get it by now, you can use the inequality on the top of the screen or the graphical method below. As usual, I have simplified the equation above to make calculation easier. And with the usual assumption, we can see that mixed node is surely better than single node AP-wise if the single drop bonus is at most 1. Meaning, as I said at the beginning, no simplified rule this time, you should always check the complete criteria. Before we move on to the actual farming setups, I will put here the usual important farming tips, in case you are a new player, together with my personal rules when it comes to ranking farming setups. These are the rules that I've always followed when listing the farming setups from best to worst. In this simplified format of videos, I will instead use them in order to give you the best farming setup and to rank the DPS that are involved in the following best farming setups. When it comes to single nodes, Space Sister is definitely the best option in this event. She has 30% bonus damage, so she is nearly a pseudo berserker this time. On top of that, you'll get the materials drop bonus and a bond bonus for bond farming if you use her. If you have her at least at MP2, you can safely use this 6-slot setup that doesn't require order change, so you can also level up other mystic codes. Instead, if like me you have her at MP1, you can simply use the event damage C for a perfectly consistent 5-slot setup. It's the combination of drop bonus and bond bonus for Space Sister that makes her the best choice. But of course, given the usual 3-3-3 layout for the single nodes, you can also use other Earth's AoE DPS. Sandar Musashi is the other universal one, Fion and Meltris Lancer for the bronze node, Chiara for the silver node, and Summer Jean for the gold node. In any case, you will find a demonstration at the end of the video with my personal farming setup. Just keep in mind that it will be different from the setup on the screen, since even if I formulate them, I can't always replicate the optimal farming setups I came up with. Moving on to the mixed level 90 plus node, it has an unusual layout of 2-1-3, with all the enemies being lancers. It drops all shop currencies and all building materials. Use the previous section of the video to decide if it's worth farming this node or the single nodes for both shop currencies and building materials. Regarding ascension materials, Dragon Scale is the only one with a better drop rate compared to free quests. It's an old mat, so chances are that you have already a lot of them, but keep in mind that append skills are a thing now, so check your servants carefully. Now some tips on how to deal with this node. Your best option is to use an AoE Arth DPS from extra Berserker or Zebra class to deal with both room 1 and room 3. In particular, you will buff him or her in room 1, making her or him loop, and then you will have the damage ready for room 3. Alternatively, you can use Gong without damage C to deal with room 1 only, or with damage C to deal with all rooms. I don't advise this second option, since even if he is a bonus servant with bonus drops for materials, making him loop all three rooms will require a team full of top tier supports, meaning you will lose a lot of drop bonus from your backline servants. Finally, you also have the option of using an AoE Buster Saber DPS with MP Charge, aka OG Artoria. This strategy might not be the best one, but it has an advantage of being able to use Castoria buffs for the secondary DPS that has to deal with room 2, meaning that one won't need any damage C. Speaking about room 2, your only real option is to use a single target Saber DPS with MP Charge, with either support capabilities for the primary DPS or very high damage in order to leave all the buffs from supports to the primary DPS. Among these primary DPS that have to deal with room 1 and room 3, Space Sister is once again your best choice, given her damage bonus, drop bonus and 50% MP charge. This is even more true if you have her at high MP levels. Second place goes to Musashi, which has the best damage and the best refund for this node, but lacking an MP charge, she requires support even from the secondary DPS in order to loop. In third place I've put both Summer Tomoe and OG Artoria. Summer Tomoe is at the moment our best AoE Arts Looping Saber, but even then her damage will be lower than both Space Sister and Summer Musashi. If you still didn't know about the memes of Summer Tomoe needing a buffs, now you know why. Finally, OG Artoria is the only AoE Buster DPS that I will recommend with double Castoria. She has the highest MP charge, and thanks to Dragon Core she can deal a respectable amount of damage in room 3, even without Buster buffs from supports. When it comes to the secondary DPS that has to deal with room 2, Bride is definitely the top choice in this case, since she can enable a lot of looping DPS for room 1 thanks to her 30% MP charge and MP gain buffs, while also giving them the highest possible amount of attack buff compared to all other choices. In second place we have Benihema, which can give effectively 40% MP charge for the team, while also giving a very good attack buff for the primary DPS, on par with Pride if you use her defense down in room 3. I've put those two in first and second place respectively, since they can support the primary DPS, meaning you can choose him or her from a larger pool. However, both of them will require either higher MP levels or the damage C in order to deal with room 2. Instead, in third place I've put the DPS that can deal with room 2 without the damage C. Saito with the 100% damage bonus is your best option, since it also gives you an extra drop bonus. However, remember that it doesn't have any NP charge skills, so if you don't mind the extra materials, you can use Bedi or Summer Hokusai for a more flexible setups thanks to their NP charge skills. I will now put here the best farming setups I came up with, using the DPS that I have listed so far. As always, I prioritize drop bonus, so 6 slot setup first and foremost. However, most of these setups can be adjusted using the damage sheaf from the event, and in fact that's exactly what I'll do in the farming demonstration you will find at the end of this video. Be sure to read and check each setup carefully, and if you find any error, please let me know in the comment section below. As a final note, remember that building materials will be useless once you have cleared the event. To be precise, you'll only get a very small amount of rupees, so feel free to use a lower ranking setup that don't use bonus servants once you have finished farming for building materials. That's all for this video, guys. I will now leave you to the farming demonstration with my farming setups. If you have found this type of content useful, please let me know by leaving a like, a comment and subscribing to the channel. It will for sure motivate me to come back in full force once I have dealt with my exams. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, I will see you next time. Bye bye!
まだまだ未熟者ですが、頑張ります。
破壊する。メガニゲモンたち
は早がきですよ、カルメン。破壊せよ、行きます。
参拝の時
やります。
アリのように並びなさい。これが本当の私。始まりは極小、広がりは無限、すべて我が心臓に収まりよ。ミシビラクエーサ
ー、ノブノノブノノブ。
早がきですね、カルエンジ。
イグナチの
準備。
うるさい。
下がっているように。
信頼回避、臨界、始まりの領域、花開く命の水、すべてひとときの夢だった。ウルスラクエーサ
であれば、白兵戦士、行きます。
耐えてみせる。
散歩。
うるさい、静かにして。信頼回避、臨界、始まりの領域、花開く命の池、すべてひとときの夢のよう。ブルースグラクエーサ
ー、ノブノノブ。
当然とはいえ嬉しいものですね。皆さんのおかげです。 この因果が娘に報いってね。
今のうちに準備する。
やだな、戦いですか。
もちろん
キョーンと使おうか。
仮のように並びなさい。信頼回避臨界、始まりの領域、花開く命の中、すべてひとときの領域、ロビウス・ブラックエーサ
ー、ハニョン。
エドッコア、サツキの声の吹き流し、キリフリクロワーズ、アオイ、ドーベン、ヨーロー、オノ、アムダッシュ、ショコ、アキメデ。静か、黙って、信頼回避臨界、始まりの領域、花開く命の中、すべてひとときの領域、降り
るものですか。
ハニョン、
私は善と悪が合体した究極の私、負ける道理がないのだわ。